In this demonstration, I will show you how to make this jacket. This is the style that we make in Pattern Making 2 class. The features of the style are notched collar, slashed bound pockets, two-piece sleeve, and a small vent belonging to the back side of the two-piece sleeve. The whole jacket is fully lined, and the lining feature here is so-called action pleat that is needed. Then there's a small pleat at the bottom of the jacket at the hemline. There's a small pleat, also small pleat at the hemline of the sleeve. So all these are needed for functional lining. Notice that this type of lining does not require back facing. Front facing is a continuation of the top collar, and the lining covers as a whole long round seam along the facing, top collar, facing, and all the way down to hem. So first step, when you start making the jacket, sew all seams that you have. You have at least one type of princess line there. Sew all the seams. Front, this is the side panel, center back seam, side panel, and front. Notice also that a hemline has been interfaced before sewing the princess lines and all the long seams. Front part is interfaced, back is interfaced, and if you have pockets, as you should, the area for the pockets must be also interfaced. Then, once you have the jacket self finished with long seams, sew lining. Completely ready to be placed, put together with self. Here's the action pleat. Action pleat, sleeves sewn in, and all the seams, whatever you have, princess seams maybe, or just side seams, and the sleeves sewn in with armholes. And notice that this is also a two-piece sleeve, even though this could be one-piece sleeve as well with one underseam. So full lining, complete lining, all princess seams sewn, and last thing to sew is the shoulder seams together. First step is to sew the notched collar. Notched collar is consisted of three pieces, top collar, and two under collar pieces. There's a center back seam on the under collar, and center back has bias crane. Bias at center back for under collar, top collar is one piece, and center back has straight grain line. To create this notch collar type, start with the shoulder seams. Send back and front together at shoulder seams. press the seams open. And now we have a complete neckline, and we can sew the collar into the neckline. We have a complete neckline here, ready for collar. Okay, next step is to sew the two back collar pieces together at center back seam, and here we have half inch seam allowance. And next we'll be joining top collar and under collar together. Top collar and under collar together. Start it from the collar corner, sew towards center back, back to collar corner, and end at a gorge line point. Leave the gorge lines unsewn. I just like to do it in three steps, starting from collar corner, evenly. Top collar is a little bit wider, 1/8 of an inch wider. So you, when you match the edges, they will be even. And then the two corners seam goes from collar corner to gorge line. Okay, and then understitch. Understitching means you pull the seam allowances towards under collar and sew on the underside of under collar as close as possible to the original seam line, first seam line. press the the whole collar, all seams, the whole collar very well. And if your corners are bulky, trim some of the seam allowances so that you get sharp corners. Clip the seam allowances. Press the collar so that under collar is inside and top collar covers the under collar. First the center back seam open, then under collar is in underneath, and top collar fully covers the under collar. When you compare under collar and top collar, notice that top collar extends wider. Under collar is shorter, top collar is wider. And that is what we need to cover part of the front, so that when we open and turn the lapel, you won't see lining underneath. Okay, this collar is ready to be sewn into the neckline. I like to start sewing the under collar onto the neckline, starting at center back. Match center back of your jacket and center back of your under collar. Proceed towards shoulder seams, neckline corner, and towards gorge line, and you should have a small notch right at the end of the gorge line. When you come to the point where the gorge line, neckline corner and gorge line corner, stop and slash the seam allowance underneath. Slash the seam allowance, then pivot and join the collar to the lapel at gorge line. This is so-called corner seam. From shoulder point to neckline corner and then gorge line, and you should have a free collar corner and free lapel corner. Same thing on the other side. Start from the center back and aim towards shoulder seam. Then next step would be the neckline corner. And stop. Slash the seam allowance. And pivot and sew the gorge line. Okay, here it is, corner seam. And then press seam allowances open. So that the construction is smooth and flat underneath the collar. All seam allowances should be pressed open, butterflied, on both sides. Then next step is to connect the facing with the lapel and gorge line. Notice the shape of the hem allowance here. The hem allowance is 1.5 inches, while here at the area which is covered by facing, it is only 1/2 inch. Right sides together. So the facing to the neckline and hem and front edge, or the lapel, actually, lapel. at the hemline, leave half inch of the facing unsewn. We need this for lining. Half inch unsewn at the bottom of the facing. And then the lapel corner here. Okay, here it is. Turn it to the inside. Facing goes inside. And then last step is to join the top collar and facing together at crotch line. Four seams come together. Four seams. Top collar and facing, lapel and facing, under collar and neckline, and the collar corner. So four seams must come together in that one intersection here. Here's the construction. And again, press seam allowance open underneath the crotch line. Seam allowances must be opened. Same thing for the other side. Facing and lapel. And the lapel corner. And last step is the crotch line, where top collar and facing are joined. then press all the seams open here underneath the gorge line. Seams need to be open. Turn facing on the inside and press very smoothly the collar area. Same thing on the other side. First, underneath the lapel, the gorge line, seam allowances open. The hem area. Now we have the collar ready. Collar is ready. We still need sleeves. And these are the pieces you need for the two-piece sleeve. Pieces needed for two-piece sleeve, undersleeve and top sleeve, vent area and the hem is interfaced, underneath the underarm the area is interfaced, and we have notches that match under sleeve and top sleeve. Notches to match undersleeve and top sleeve. Here's the vent. This is how it looks when it's finished. Notice that it's not fully open, only partly, and this method works very well with the lining because lining is going to cover the rest of the sleeve. And only the bottom is open. Very easy method, especially with the lining. To make this, to finish this type of vent, these are the shapes we drafted as patterns, shapes. Start sewing from the undersleeve and fold the on the right side, fold the hem in it's ready, as if it would be ready, as the same way we drafted, and sew only 1.5 inches with 1/4 inch seam allowance, only this area. Then slash the seam allowance . Move the hem into the wrong side so it is as drafted original. Here is then the top sleeve, and same thing, fold the hem allowance with the extension of the vent to the right side. So now fully, whole vent area from bottom to top of the vent with 1/2 inch seam allowance. Slash the seam allowance and move the hem all together to the inside of the sleeve and press. Before continuing, press those parts as they should be. Next step is to join the undersleeve and top sleeve together so that they overlap 1 inch. They overlap 1 inch at the hemline. Start matching. Start from the vent, but top of the vent, match the notches and sew the back part of the two-piece sleeve. Right on top of the vent, start sewing and then match the notches. Here they are. And last step is to join the two parts of the vent. It's still fully open. We need to sew it together so that it doesn't open all the way. And again, you need to clip seam allowances open so that you can press the rest of the seam properly. From top of the vent to the end of the under sleeve vent seam allowance. This can be a round seam or a square seam, either or. There it is. Partly open and looks fully functional on the right side. And then press seam allowance open and press the vent. And last step for the two-piece sleeve is to sew the front part of the two-piece sleeve. Front part of the two-piece sleeve. Fold the hem allowance in its place. Press the seam allowances open. And then treat the cap with gathering stitches and pressing. Make really long stitch lines along the cap. Thank you. Treat the ease of the cap evenly on front and back sides as needed. And press and shrink the ease of the cap. With steam. The seam. Now the sleeves are ready to be set in. With the two armholes. Match the underarm points, match the top of the cap, and sew as circles. With the ease, it should be suitable now that we treated it with shrinking and gathering. Armholes and sleeve cap should be equal after treating it with steam. after setting the sleeve, do not press anymore. Maybe a little bit of steam around the cap so that it settles smoothly in its place. And no wrinkles or gathers or pleats, just smooth round ease only. First match underarm points, then match cap point, top of the cap sleeve with shoulder seam, and even out the rest of the ease between front and back. And so on the side of the sleeve, not on the side of the armhole or front jacket, back. Jacket is basically ready. This is called the shell. When you have all the parts sewn in, but no lining yet. This is the shell. Now if you want shoulder pads, you would attach shoulder pads to the seam allowance of the shoulder, and along the shoulder seam allowance few stitches. Shoulder pad would be this step right now, but in this case we move on and attach the lining. Lining is completely ready, just like the shell. And before you continue, check few things. The length of the sleeve, that it matches well with the length of your jacket sleeve. Match center back points and make sure that you have enough length to create that pleat. Your hem allowance is 1.5 inches. 1.5 inches hem allowance, and then your center back lining should reach 1/2 inch above the finished hem of the jacket, and lining and hem of the jacket would match on the same level. So this is what you need to match: the length of the lining with the length of the jacket, and the length of the hem. Fold 1/2 inch on the lining. Fold 1/2 inch, match it 1/2 inch with the jacket, and then go towards center back. Make sure that the distance is same. Center from front to center back, and then from center back to front with 1/2 inch folded. So this distances have to be exactly the same. start sewing the lining from sleeves. Good idea is to pin the sleeve and lining at the matching seam point. Pin the sleeve and the lining at the matching seam and make sure that it's not twisted inside, that the lining is not twisted inside the self. It's smooth. And then pull the sleeve and lining out. And sew almost as a circle from vent to the first seam. And then almost a circle ending at the vent as well. Almost a circle. This is almost a circle, but you cannot sew it truly around because we have the vent. You need to leave 1 or 2 wide opening here at the vent area. Otherwise, it's like a continuation of the sleeve. And then all you got to do is to pull it inside and you can check that it works. Here it is. Same thing with the other sleeve. First check the length of the sleeve and match seam points with the lining so that it lining is not twist it inside the sleeve. And then pull lining out and sew it as almost a circle. here's the other sleeve, same way, almost a full circle, and then pull the lining inside the jacket as it should be and check that it is not twisted and all together in right position. Okay, then we sew the front edge, neckline, and back to the front edge. Start from hem points. This is very critical that you get this part right. The hem facing and lining hem intersection. This is very important to have it strong, clean, and functional. Fold the hem of the lining, matching with the hem of the jacket shell. Fold the hem allowance of the lining and match it with the jacket shell. Remember, you have half inch, lining should be higher than the jacket itself. And start sewing these two edges together. Then continue sewing this edge towards center back and stop at center back. Start at the hem point, and this is how you should treat this hem corner. Slash the seam allowance and tuck the bottom part, the hem area, towards facing. Tuck it towards facing. And then sew on top, not through all layers, but only facing seam allowances and hem allowance. here's the corner point. Facing seam allowances towards facing slash the seam allowance here, and rest will stay as it is, and you have a nice clean corner. Then the other side, start the same way. Fold lining hem half in, 1 inch, because that's how much we had. Raise it, start the lining from half inch from bottom of the shelf hem, and continue so all the way up to center back. All is ready except hem. So start from the corner point, corner, then sew all the way to center back. Start from the corner, sew towards center back, and that is the easiest way to get it smoothly. Now all we got to do is to finish the hem. We need to leave an opening somewhere. Sometimes it's left in the sleeve. I like to keep center back as the opening. I have more control how of the final result that way. So I start from the finished tuck area from here, this part, towards center back, and I leave about 4 or 5 inches depending on the thickness of the fabric and the size of the garment unsewn here at the center back area. But I still have this one tuck. One more time, this is the corner. This is the corner of facing, lining, and hem. Slash seam allowance, tuck those seam allowances towards facing, and so not through all layers, but catching facing seam allowances and hem allowance only. And then this is ready for the hem joining, the hem of the lining and hem of the jacket. Method is called bagged lining because it is like inside a bag. Start from as close as possible to the corner. As close as you can. If it's tight, don't force it. As close as you possibly can. And then match hem of the lining and hem of the self and sew them together with half inch seam allowance here. And when you approach center back, just leave that area open. Everything is inside a bag, and all I'm doing is working on the hem area. Same thing on the other side. Start from the corner as close as possible and match seams so that there's an evenness. Okay, last step is when the whole lining has been sewn. We need to turn it right side out. And here it is. Finished lining needs a good press. Everything still needs to be pressed before sewing the buttons and a few tucks. Press the hem really strongly. Press the strong hemline here. Press the lining so that it's half inch above the hem of the self, hand stitch the center back opening. Add few tucks through the seam crevice. So few tucks so that the hem will stay in place. Tuck the underarm points through all layers. Here at the underarm, small hand tucks. Sew the back collar along the seam. Sew it into the jacket so that it stays. For example, from shoulder point to shoulder point, sew it through all layers. And all you got to do is to add few buttons, couple of buttons here at the vent so that it stays closed the way it should be. And buttonholes and buttons will be the last step. And your jacket is ready.